It's beer o'clock on Real Ale Craft Beer. Today we've got a beer from Blue Monkey Brewery and it's the Gorilla Stout coming in at 4.9% ABV. It's an award-winning or a multiple award-winning stout from the Midlands. So I'm looking forward to this. I've drunk a lot of their golden ales, their pale ales, their IPAs, their slightly darker beers, but not a stout. So, I like stout, it's one of my favourite styles. Stouts and porters. Look at that! And I've mentioned this before, very recently, regarding a Scottish brewery. And I mentioned the fact that I just had a funny feeling that through their golden ales, through tasting and reviewing their golden ales, that they would produce an amazing stout, and they did. And I've got the same feeling with this brewery. This brewery, with their pale ales, their IPAs, their golden ales, they were nice and hoppy, but they kind of lent back into the maltiness of a good beer. It had a solid malty backbone. When you take that into consideration, when you think about that, then you know that the brewer know their malts. They know how to use their malts. Then it's not an afterthought. But when they produce IPAs, they're all very balanced and they're all very nice. But there's just something about it that they can produce a great stout. And I had the feeling with this that they would be able to produce a great stout. So I've got high hopes for this beer. It's jet black, it's a one finger, slightly off-white head with nice levels of carbonation. Can you get the carbonation? I think you can. Let's get the aroma. And boom! That smells absolutely fantastic. It's rich, it's dark, it's chocolatey, there's a hint of coffee, caramel, and yes! Yes! I am screaming for the rooftops because before tasting this beer, before putting it to my lips and drinking it, I'm going to make quite a bold statement and say before I've even tried this beer, just by the aroma, that this is Blue Monkey Brewery's best beer. Let's go ahead and check it out. Yeah. Yes. This is brilliant. This is absolutely brilliant. This is how a stout should be in my mind. This is how I picture stout. This is how I see stout. This is stout, stout, and more stout. It's got a lovely, rich, velvety mouthfeel. It's almost lactosey, creamy. And that's a great foundation. That's the foundations of this whole beer, the mouthfeel. And then it goes on to be chocolate and bitter coffee and bitter dark chocolate at that. And then a sweet caramel. And then that lovely kind of velvety feeling, that lovely mouthfeel that I keep going back to, I keep mentioning. I personally, and it's a personal preference, I'm not really a fan of the dry Irish stout. For me, dry Irish stout is a refreshing stout. It's a stout that's very thin. It's a stout that is refreshing. You could mow the lawn and go and drink a dry Irish stout and refresh yourself. Where this, if you really wanted to, you could probably push it to be refreshing. It's certainly a liquid. But it's more of a sipper. It's more of a sit back, relax, put your feet up, smooth the dog, and drink this stout. The carbonation in this beer just lifts it up enough. It's not too aggressive. The worst thing this beer could be, in my mind, if the carbonation levels were too high and it was ruining that mouthfeel. So there's a lot to consider with stout. It's not just that it's creamy. It could be overcarbonated. It's not. It could be thin. It's not. It could be just small hints of chocolate, coffee, caramel, but it's not. This combines, for me, this combines to be almost brilliant. It's almost a brilliant beer. And yet, you want my opinion, but before I do so, I want to mention the bitterness on the back end. There's a nice level of bitterness that I almost forgot to tell you about. It's all reined in. It's all within a bubble. Everything's pulling the strings inside the bubble to make it a perfect circle. It's not like a distorted balloon when it's pulling off in other directions. Everything's working together, from the mouthfeel, from the creaminess, from the taste, from the carbonation, and then from that lovely subtle bitterness on the back end. Everything is working together. It's almost like teamwork in a glass. Rating. Let's just get ahead and rate it. If I seen this again, I think I would drink pint after pint after pint of this beer. It's just one of them go-to favourite stouts. And yes, for me, it's their best beer. This is Blue Monkey Brewery's pioneer beer. This is the beer that probably made them as a brewery. I'm going to give this, yeah, why not, a 10 out of 10. It's a 10 out of 10 from Real Ale Craft Beer. Put your comments in the comments box. Please subscribe to our daily beer reviews, and cheers.